Hi everybody, it's Carolina. Welcome back to my channel. So I'm going to try to do another quick video. I want to first apologize for my last video. Apparently there must have been some file corruption with my camera. Again, I have had so much issues with transferring my files over from my camera to my computer to edit them, and then I think it's doing well. I see the video on my computer and everything seems to be going fine. Next thing you know, I upload it. Turns out that like half of my video is gone, and I'd really like to apologize for that. Unfortunately, once I upload my video to the internet, I delete it from my computer. I deleted it from my actual SD card, and I think that once you do that, that's pretty much it, because there was just no way that I could fix it. So I want to apologize for that. For this video, what I wanted to do was kind of give a shout out to new to me brands. This was a Topic Tuesday. It was for the month of December, but I can't remember what week it was. New to me brands that I have fallen completely in love with in 2018. This is not my favorites of 2018 video. That's another video that's coming up, but this is just my new to me brands that I absolutely loved. The first brand that I want to talk about is Pahlish. I'm sorry, I'm like a little kid. Every time I try to say that name, it makes me want to laugh. Anyways, this brand, I have heard about this brand for a very long time. I just never purchased them. I don't know why, honestly, but I have to tell you guys, if you haven't purchased from Pahlish, you need to. This brand is amazing. Every polish that I have purchased from this brand, either in a D-stash or from the actual website, has been amazing. The formula has been amazing. The uniqueness of the polish, the longevity of wear time. I just have loved everything about this brand. The first polish that I picked up from Pahlish was actually in a D-stash, and this was Madame Mim. Sorry, I didn't shake it. Let me shake it up so you guys can see what it looks like, all nice and shook. So Madame Mim was the first polish that I ever purchased from this brand. I purchased it in a D-stash. I was actually looking for Polish for Days Animalese because I had missed out on that from Polish Pickup, but I saw this and I said, oh, I think that would be similar. They're not, but this is still amazing. I still love it. I wore it on my hands and my toes. Whenever I put something on my hands and my toes, that's saying like, wow, this polish is amazing. Even my husband notices if I have the same color on my hands and my toes. He's like, wow, that must be a really good polish for you. To get it completely opaque, I did do a third because I like to make it a little bit more intense. I don't know what it is, but I always feel that colors like these, or just in general sheer, like this type of polish, even though they cover in two coats, I feel that they look better with a third. It just brings the intensity. The next polish that I have from Pahlish is actually one that a friend of mine, next thing you know, she shows me a picture of this polish. This is Gilded Olive from Pahlish. And this polish became my unicorn for the latter half of 2018. I want to say I saw this in June of 2018. Maybe it was May or June of 2018. I saw this polish and I just like, oh my God, what is that? Everywhere I looked, it was gone. It was gone. Nobody wanted to sell it. Nobody wanted to de-stash it. And the ones that were on D-stash, they were gone. And I was just freaking out because I needed this polish in my life. If you guys don't know already, purples and greens are like my favorite colors to wear. And golds. Anyways, all the colors of the rainbows. But purples and greens, I definitely gravitate towards more than any other color. This color had me like literally salivating. You guys saw that I swallowed. I had to swallow. I was literally salivating for this color. This color was like me in a bottle, basically. I always laughed when people said, oh, this is my me in a bottle. And I'm like, I don't get it. I don't have me in a bottle. This is me in a bottle, guys. This one right here. The next polish I actually got, because Josephine from Pahlish Talk posted a picture on her Instagram and she had this polish on, or it was an accent nail, I think. And I was just like, oh my God, what is this? And then I read the name and I thought it was the best name ever. It's Glittoris from Pahlish. And this is a pink, which I normally do not gravitate towards at all, but there is something magical about this pink. I cannot get enough of this pink. It is one of those polishes that I was just like, okay, I have to find this one. And I'm so thankful. I really love this polish and cannot wait to put it. The next new to me brand that I want to talk about is a brand that is very famous, and I think it's very famous. I had heard about it for a while, but I was never into their type of the way that they release their polishes. It seems that everybody went frantic for it and everything sold out really quickly, and it really annoyed me that it was set up that way, and it kind of still is, but I decided to give it a chance. And of course I'm talking about Tonic polish, and these two polishes I bought at the same time. I was lucky enough to be aware of the sale while it, like, right before it happened, so then I was able to go and get it. So I never knew what was happening, and that's why I think I was like so I didn't really want to get into the whole Tonic craze, but I was lucky enough to get into this sale at the time that I could. And this is, of course, Happenstance and Bauble. That's what I do when I'm on the camera. Happenstance is the first one that I purchased from them. I mean, the minute I saw this, I said, I must have this. And I put it on my cart right away. I love this polish. This polish is just, oh, it's so pretty. I mean, I have no words. I'm not good at describing these things. I just let you know that this is pretty and I loved it. The formula was fantastic. The formula is very sheer. It has to be to let all these fantastic colors and flakies shine through. I think it looks amazing. It looks spot on perfect. And then of course there's Bauble. Bauble is basically the same concept as Happenstance, however it's in an indigo blue base. I don't know if you guys can see, it's a little bit more blue. I actually remember which one I put this over, but I put this over OPI. Do you have this color in Stockholm? Or yeah, do you have this color in Stockholm, I think it's called. But I like to put Bauble over that one because I feel like it gives it that color, that OPI color is kind of a blurple, and this is kind of a blurple, and I feel like it gives it the perfect match to make this color exactly on the nails without having to do three coats. So after those colors, I still wasn't really into Tonic as much. However, I would find their sales and you know, look at their stuff, and I sometimes would find good stuff and sometimes I wouldn't. But this color, I had to have the minute that I saw it. I saw it and I said, oh my God, I am not a thermal polish wearer, but for some reason this needed to be in my life, and I am so glad I did. This is Tonic's River. River is, it is a thermal, it is fantastic. I don't care what color it settles on. Like, I know that one of the things about thermals is that they're not long lasting. They last about, what, 6 months to a year, and then they kind of like settle either to their warm state or their cold state. So I don't like getting thermals because I always thought, well, I don't want, what if I don't like the cold state as much as a warm state, or vice versa? This, I don't care. I love it. I love it. Absolutely fell in love with was Taunt Lizard Dance. Lizard Dance came out of nowhere for me because I was not expecting to like it as much as I did. I got it because I wanted kind of this effect for the fall season, and I was given this one, and another one was recommended for me. I can't remember the other one's name right now. And I decided to go with this one because I just felt that, I don't know, this one was a little bit more unique. And holy cow, it is so shifty, so pretty. The formula was fantastic. It was opaque in two coats, and I got so many compliments when I wore this polish. The third new to me brand that I absolutely fell in love with this year is Dreamland, and I actually found them through Polish Pickup. My first polish was from Polish Pickup, and this is You Look Like Seafood. Oh my God, guys. When I saw the preview pictures for this polish, I knew I was gonna get it. Like, I knew it. I was like, there's no ifs, ands, or buts. This is coming home with me. And I'm so glad that I did. This polish, this formula was amazing. I mean, it applied like butter. And I got it opaque in two coats, and I just couldn't stop looking at my nails. I could not stop looking at my nails. This is like one of my top top polishes from 2018. The last Dreamland lacquer that I have is actually from a from the last polish pickup. No. From November's polish pickup. Sorry, I thought it was December's polish pickup. But this is Queen of the Iceni? I don't know how to say that. This polish is a green version of You Look Like Seafood. And hello, purple, green. I had to have it. I definitely do not regret getting this. This is gorgeous. And the number one polish brand that I absolutely loved this year. The other ones, they weren't really in an order, but this number one brand, this is number one. Like, it literally is number one. It's Polish for Days. Guys, Polish for Days. I am completely speechless when it comes to this Polish brand. This Polish brand has completely blown me away every single time I purchase from them. I have not regretted my decision to purchase from them. I do regret not purchasing from them. My first Polish for Days polish was from Polish Pickup, PPU. Saw the swatch pictures for this polish and the concept art for this month. It was for the April of 2018 month for Polish Pickup, and I could not believe my eyes. It was just great. I have no words. It was beautiful, and I kept going back and forth on whether I wanted to buy it because I wanted other polishes because of the theme. However, this polish just spoke to me, and to be perfectly honest, I didn't even wear this polish until November of this year. However, I had swatched it swatched it on a swatch stick, and I also had put it on my best friend's daughter, and I was just like, oh my God, this is gorgeous, gorgeous. And I could not stop thinking about this brand. And every time I would see them on Polish Pickup, they would be some amazing concoction. And so I went to their website and just kind of went. We have been purchasing every Polish Pickup for Polish for Days every month. I have been looking at their website, and every time they come, anytime I see something on a D-stash, I snatch it up with a quickness just because I know that I'm going to love it. They have so many beautiful polishes. You cannot go wrong with a Polish for Days polish. This one here is Solar Flare, the first polish that I purchased from them. This is magic in a bottle, guys. You guys have no idea. I'm not gonna talk about all of the Polish for Days polishes that I have because it's a lot and this video would be all about them. Honestly, I kind of feel like I should have just made the video all about them anyways, but I wanted to be fair and show my love for the other new to me brands that I absolutely fell in love with this year. But I'm gonna talk a little bit about the other polishes from Polish for Days that I absolutely love. The second favorite Polish for Days polish is Gray Opal, and I got this in the July re-release of 2018, and I'm so glad they re-released this polish. I mean, they could have done any other polish, but this polish I was actually looking for since 2017 because I think Miss Holly Berry's had mentioned it in her fall of 2017 favorites, I think it was. And I was like, oh, that's beautiful. And I went hunting for it, but I wasn't really like, you know, it's just a polish. I didn't know how amazing Polish for Days was. I didn't realize how amazing they were. And so I wanted this polish, but I wasn't like, oh my God, I need this polish. I was like, if I find it, I find it. Great. But then I fell in love with the brand. And when they re-released this, I was like, yes, I have it finally. This polish is the polish that made me realize that I cannot pass on Polish for Days polishes. This was released in the June 2018 Polish Pickup month. And I skipped it. I don't know why I skipped it. There's no logical reason for me to skip it, but I skipped it, guys, and I regretted it immediately. And I was on the hunt for it, and nobody was destashing it. Finally, somebody destashed it, and I purchased it like that, guys. I could not say no. This is Animalese. Animalese is, oh my God. This, I have, you know, yeah. That's how Animalese is. It's freaking amazing. I love it. I'm so glad I found it. This is definitely one of my top 2018 polishes. This is so beautiful. So beautiful. I do wear this in 3 coats. It is perfectly full coverage by 2 coats, but I wear it in 3 because I like it. I like the way it looks better, and I don't regret it. I don't regret it. It's gorgeous. This color is amazing. Another one of my favorites from Polish for Days is When I Grow Up. This is another one from Polish Pickup. It is a smorgasbord of crazy flaky colors of all kinds, and I freaking love it. A really nice surprise was their cute as a button polish from September 2018 polish pickup. This color completely blew me away. I mean, I bought it because it was an auto buy. Like, literally, Polish for Days has become an auto buy. Another one that I'm really glad that I got, and it's still at the website, guys, is Kelpie. Kelpie is just, oh my gosh. There are no words for how amazing this polish is. Still at the website. If you guys want to get it, I think you guys should. Ember is another one that I am so glad I got my hands on. It looks like it should be a dupe for Animalese, but it really isn't. There's like this pink flash. This here is Ember. This is Animalese. Even though they're very similar, as in they're both purples, there's just a difference. This one is just a little bit deeper, and that pink shimmer in it makes it just, oh. And there's also kind of a green shimmer to it as well. I don't know if you guys will be able to tell. It's hard to tell in the video, but in real life you can see it, especially like at an angle. Like, as I'm looking at it, like at an angle here, I can definitely tell that it has like a greenish shift. It's so amazing. Hawthorne actually made me gasp out loud. I took this out and I actually gasped. I went when I opened the package and opened this off, took it out of its bubble wrap, I was just like, oh my God, this is gorgeous. I have not worn it yet. I don't know why. I think it was, I was doing Chocolate November, and I don't know why I just didn't get a chance to wear this, and I just haven't worn it yet, but it is gorgeous and I can't wait to put it on my hands and toes. Another one that was recommended to me when I couldn't figure out what else to put in my cart because there's just too many beautiful polishes to purchase and you're on a budget. This was recommended to me. This is Fireflies. Fireflies is just, oh gosh, guys, you guys have no idea. This is still on the site. This is what I love about Polish for Days too, that their collections stay on the site for a very long time, so you don't have to feel this rush of, oh my God, I need to get it right now because it's going to be gone in a second. She lets you know if it's going to be gone quickly. So I really appreciate that. Phoneix is another one that actually made me gasp out loud, guys. This polish is just amazing. Look at that. Look at that. It really does look like fiery embers in this purple base. And it's a purple because, of course, I could not go without buying a purple. But this polish, oh my gosh, it is so gorgeous. I kid you not, guys, if you have not purchased Polish for Days, I urge you to try them out either in a polish pickup or on their website. Jenna, the creator and owner of Polish for Days, makes such amazing polishes. It's like she's a freaking wizard. A freaking wizard, guys. I kid you not. So anyways, thanks so much for sticking with me for this, again, long video that I try to make really short. So thank you so much for watching, and I hope you guys have a great day. Bye.